Hi, my name is Sarah Rae. Welcome back to my channel, and today is the third part in our Def Leppard High and Dry series of going through the album. Today we are going to look at You Got Me Runnin' and Lady Strange. But before we go into that, I wanted to say something a little off topic, is that I was kind of thinking of what my favorite Def Leppard song, and right away it hit me, and I got to thinking, when was this song created? And it was 1996. It's When Love and Hate Collide. I absolutely love that song, and it has to be my favorite. And it kind of threw me back when I found out it was 1996. I was like, wait, it was? That sucks a little bit. And so I looked it up, and I found something a little interesting, was that the original demo version contained the final recording guitar solo from Steve Clark. And if anyone can find that, I would love to hear that. I absolutely would. I don't know if it's possible to find that, but if it is. And then tell me who the guitar soloist is in this song, if it's Phil Collin or Vivian Campbell. Exactly what is going on in that song. So, like, guitar wise, tell me what you know, because I would love to hear about it. But anyways, you guys know the drill. Like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications of when I upload. You know the game we're playing. I'm going to tell you who the guitar soloists are in these two songs, and you're going to let me know whether I'm right or wrong. So far, we have a great track record, and let's see if we can keep it up. Let's get into the music. There's one more thing I want to say that I forgot to mention in the intro before we get into the to You Got Me Runnin', is why we don't do music videos on this channel. And this is for the new subscribers and people who probably don't know why. And it's because I'm kind of all over the place. I get distracted really easy. So when I'm watching music videos, I tend to focus too into the music videos than what's happening in the song, like the instruments and everything. So I prefer to not watch the music videos. Instead, I listen to the song so I can really indulge in what's happening musically. So, like, the instruments, the flow, the vocals, everything. So, it really allows me to spend my time absorbing the music than having to split my focus on the music and the music video. And then I watch the music video on my own time. I'm just kind of a little bit behind on my music videos right now, but with that out of the way, now let's get into the music. All right. This feels like a very in-your-face song, like Get Out of My Way type of a song already. Right off the bat, I'm getting that vibe. Yeah. right? This is like a song you just want to put the devil horns up and just, yes. Pete Willis. So Pete Willis. Yeah. Beautiful. Pete Willis is such a talent. Oh my God. That was beautiful. You Got Me Runnin. Oh my God. Where was this song when I was in high school getting bullied and not taking the shit from those people? Honestly, I feel like this song is pretty much about that type of situation, like getting bullied or getting two-timed or backstabbed and not taking that crap from any of those situations. I mean, he clearly states, "You got me running, but I ain't gonna hide." I absolutely love that. I mean, if anybody takes anything from Def Leppard, I think it's this song right here. I love how the instruments set up Joe Elliott's vocals for this song. I think the guitar solo was Pete Willis, which was a phenomenal guitar solo, by the way. I went back on my own time and listened to all the songs up to Switch 625, and I started putting little check marks by the songs that I really liked the most, like picking what songs I liked the most out of all the songs I've listened to so far, to help me when I'm doing Pyromania and Hysteria, so I can go in compare notes to really pick out what album is the best. And so far with this album, the ones I really enjoyed so far, like, not that I didn't, don't take it that I didn't enjoy the other songs, because I did, but not as much as I'm enjoying the other songs, okay? Let's just get that out of the way. So, Let It Go, Bring In On The Heartbreak, of course, Switch 625. You had to have known that. And then now, You Got Me Runnin'. I have to say, out of all the songs, I think You Got Me Runnin' is number one, and then Switch 625 is number two. But I'm in love with this song. I absolutely just vibe with it. I don't know what it is about it. It's everything. But with that being said, let's check out Lady Strange. See what it's all about. That's nice. I'm getting the vibe that Steve's the lead right now. And it's not a solo, it just sounds like Steve is like head. Does that make sense? I don't know.
Yeah.
Come on. We all know damn well who this is. Do I have to say it? Can I, like, opt out of it? Like, come on. So that was Lady Strange. Real quick, I forgot to mention High and Dry Saturday Night was on the list as well. So the list is Let It Go, High and Dry Saturday Night, Bring It On the Heartbreak, Switch 625, and You Got Me Runnin'. Okay, now that that's out of the way, Lady Strange. Honestly, you know we keep it real on this channel. It's my least favorite song on the album. Lyrically, okay? Lyrically, I wasn't vibing with it. Instrumentally wise, is that even a word? It is today. It was gold. The guitar work, the drums, you know, the background stuff, gold. I loved it. Guitar solo, you guys, come on. That was so my beloved Steve Clark on the guitar. I'm gonna guess what the song is about. Meeting someone who's very unique. I guess that's why they call her Lady Strange. He fell in love with her. I don't know. It's a very interesting song. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Very interesting. Alright, so let's recap You Got Me Runnin' and Lady Strange. You Got Me Runnin', I absolutely loved, just wow, blew me away. Definitely top favorite out of the album so far. Definitely Pete Willis on the guitar. Lady Strange, definitely the amazing Steve Clark on the guitar. Which was, I think, the greatest part of the song, period. you guys might disagree with me. It's just opinions, you guys. So, my opinion, I just didn't really like the song too much. And that's gonna happen, you know? Not everyone's gonna like the same songs. Trying to think, is there anything else I have to say about the songs? I don't think so. They were great. Let me know if I'm wrong on the guitar solos or if I'm right. Next week we got Mirror Mirror and How did this go wrong? Okay. I have no idea what happened. My phone messed up and took out one of the songs. Okay. So, next week is On Through the Night and Mirror Mirror. So, we will look forward to that next week. And, you're getting two videos this week of Def Leppard. Tomorrow on Sunday, we're going to do Def Leppard's White Lightning, which I hear is a dedication to Steve Clark. So, I look forward to listening to it. And with that all said, there's nothing else to say. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Bye.